Well, good morning, church family. It is Friday morning, April the 3rd, the first day of our stay-at-home order. And I know some of you, maybe the last couple of weeks, and especially today, are starting to have some anxiety issues, starting to have some worry, starting to get concerned about what's going on in our community and in the world and our nation and in the world. So what I want to do is this, is I want to come every morning for the next couple of weeks, do a little short video, 3 to 5 minutes. Today may be a little bit longer because I have to explain it, but 3 to 5 minute video of where we get into God's word, where we look at every instance where God says, do not be afraid or fear not, and see a characteristic of him and why he is telling us in those particular texts, why he's telling us not to be afraid. Now, it's easy to say God is sovereign and we should not be afraid because God's sovereign, and that is true. But however, I think we can learn a little bit of his character in every instance and do a little quick daily devotion. Pastor Zach is doing a great job leading us on a corporate level, on a big level, and he's talking to the government, local agencies. He's talking to making huge decisions, teaching on Sunday mornings, teaching on Wednesday nights. And I asked him if I could do something like this to help us through the time, and he was more than gracious to allow me to do this. So I appreciate that. And it's just, we're trying to get through this together. And so what I want to do is every morning I want to come before you do a little scripture. I want to be thankful for something, and I want to pray for something. And so it's basically that. We are missing you guys. We're missing meeting together. And so hopefully this is a way that we can also stay connected to each other, stay connected to him. So the first fear not that I want to talk about comes out of Genesis chapter 15. And it's with Abram. And it says this, after this, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. And it says, do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield, your very great reward. But Abram said, sovereign Lord, what can you give me since I remain childless and the one who will inherit my estate is someone else, is Eliezer from Damascus. And Abram said, you have given me no children, so a servant in my household will be my heir. And the word of the Lord came to him and said, this man will not be your heir, but a son who is your own flesh and blood will be your heir. And I want to look at this. It says, God says, do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield and your very great reward. Now, what does a shield do? A shield, if you've seen any kind of Captain America or medieval thing, a shield, you hold it up and it's used for protection. And now, in this time, I want to say that God is our protector. But in this text, which doesn't mean that we're not going to get hurt or we're not going to have bad seasons or we're not going to get in trouble or whatever, but I just want to hear, in this text, God is saying, I am a protector of a promise. Because if you'll notice, Abram starts asking questions after God says that. Abram starts asking questions about the promise that God gave him that says, you're going to be the father of many nations. Your heirs are going to be like the stars in the sky, greater than the stars in the sky, and your sons. And Abraham's like, okay, Abram's like, okay, you haven't given me a son. I don't have any heir. How can this happen? So he starts asking questions about this, about God's promise. And God says, hey, I am a protector. I am a shield of that promise. And so let's think about that today. What is a promise that God has made you and me in the scriptures? What is a promise? The promise that I keep on thinking is that God will never leave us nor forsake us. And that is a promise that God he is the protector of that promise, and he will never leave us nor forsake us. So during this time, as you're going throughout your day, I'm going to ask you to do this. I'm going to ask you to turn down the volume of the media, because they're not going to be the protector of that promise. Turn down the volume of the media and turn up the volume of truth, the scriptures, and lean into the promise that God has for you and me. I know it's tough. I know it's scary sometimes. I know it can be overwhelming, but the truth is, God has promised that he would never leave us or forsake us. And he is the protector of that promise. He is our shield. And therefore, we shall not be afraid. So keep that word for you today, and I pray that that resonates with you this morning and all throughout the day as you go throughout your day today. Also, what I want to do every morning is I want to be grateful. I think it's our time to be grateful and thankful. And so right now, I want to be thankful, and I just want to say thank you to the people working in the medical field, the doctors and the nurses. Now, I know that's very close to me because my wife's a nurse, but I just want to say thank you for what you do. Going in, dealing with things that we don't see, hearing things that we don't see, and constantly doing it day after day, putting yourself at risk. I want to say thank you to those particular people, the doctors, the nurses, and everyone in the hospital, just particularly the hospitals right now, the administration, everything that keeps a hospital running. Thank you for what you are doing. You are definitely on the front lines, and it may get worse, but I just want to say thank you. And I want to encourage you guys to know that God is our shield, and He will never leave us nor forsake us. And also, what I'd like to do during these videos is I want to pray for a particular set of people, I guess you would say. And right now, my heart has been really wanting to pray for single parents during this time, that maybe their child is at home now, maybe they've lost a job, and they're just, they don't know what to do. And so my prayer is that you would pray with me as we thank the Lord for the medical staff, the doctors and the nurses, and we pray for the single parents that are struggling through this. So let's pray. Father God, we want to thank you for your son Jesus. We thank you for the grace and mercy through him. God, I thank you that you are our protector. God, that you are our shield. Lord, that you never leave us nor forsake us. And Lord, right now I just want to be grateful and say thank you for the nurses and the doctors and the administration of the hospitals that are anxiously working day by day to make decisions. And Lord, I just pray for them. I lift them up. I thank you for them. They are amazing people. And Lord, I want to pray for all of our single parents that are having a hard time right now. Lord, maybe that I've lost a job, God, that are having to teach at home and work. Lord, I don't know. Lord, I just pray for them. I pray that you would be with them. Lord, I pray that your hand would be upon them. And God, you would give them extra strength during this time to make it through. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, church family, I love you. I miss you. Zach, we talk about it. Pastor Zach and the staff talk about it a lot. We miss seeing you. We miss being with you. And during this time, my prayer is that we take our eyes off of the media and we take our eyes back and put our eyes back on Jesus. I love you. I just want to leave with this, that in Christ Jesus, there is hope. And I pray that you have hope today. God bless.